Hi, I'm Dr. Lise Briscoe. Today we're going to talk about eating for fitness, no matter what your fitness level is. If you're a couch potato versus if you're a fitness addict like me. So stay tuned. I'm an international fashion model and I'm also a doctor. We're going to talk about eating for fitness today because depending on your fitness level, there's different foods that you should be aware of eating to replenish, repair, and help build muscles. To help me discuss this is nutritionist Desiree Nazarian from Beverly Hills, and she has helped me so much already with what to eat and helping me get ready for pageants and modeling. So Desiree, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
This is a topic that's near and dear to my heart because I work out almost every day. And I remember talking to my trainer saying, I'm lifting weights quite a bit, but I'm not noticing any definition in my body. Why? And they were saying, I'm not getting enough protein once I started journaling my food. And you were telling us, how much protein do you need if you're working out?
If you're working out as rigorously as you are, I would really recommend having 1 gram of protein per pound.
So I'm 115 pounds. That means I need 115 grams of protein a day. I was getting like 70 a day. So no wonder I wasn't seeing any gains at all. And then another thing that my trainer told me is, because I'm like, how come I'm not seeing my abs? And she said, abs are built in the kitchen instead of in the gym. What do you feel about that?
So I really agree with that. The thing is that people think that when they're exercising, they can just eat whatever they want. And your diet is just as important, if not more. So I really recommend having a proper diet to help with what you want to look like, not just exercise. You can't just do whatever exercise and think that you can eat whatever you want.
I'm glad you brought that up because a lot of people say, well, you know, they're eating junk food or desserts and they'll say, don't worry, I'll work it off in the gym. And I always tell my son, you can't work it off.
Right.
In fact, and what you said is true, that what you eat is more important to your physique.
Exactly.
People who are bodybuilders, they're in contests, they are more aware about eating the right foods, and that affects how they look even more than pumping iron.
Exactly.
Desiree, I hear that protein is so important for eating for fitness. Why?
So protein is really important because it will help with building muscle, and it's important to have protein from healthy sources, so things like chicken, fish, turkey. There's also many plant-based proteins.
What about salmon?
So salmon is great because it also has omega-3 fish oils. It is a fatty fish, but it's a good fat. So it's really good for our brain function, and it's great for weight loss as well.
Skin. Yes. Yeah. And how about eggs? Because there's a controversy about whether or not you can eat eggs. But a lot of my friends who are bodybuilders, this is a big part of their diet.
I think eggs are great. I eat eggs every day. I recommend having them hard boiled because that way you don't have to use any oil. The only issue
is... How about poached? Because I love poached
eggs. Is great as well because there's no oil there either. The only thing is that if you have cholesterol, that's when I would lay off of the egg yolk and I would just stick to the egg white.
So is that true? Because I've read a lot of studies saying that really cholesterol is genetic. It's made in your bone marrow rather than it's from food. You can eat really high cholesterol and it doesn't affect your cholesterol level.
So genetics play a huge role, but your lifestyle and reducing stress and having more omega-3 fish oils and reducing the amount of cholesterol also has an impact.
Got it. And then what if you're vegan? What about plant-based proteins?
So there are a lot of plant-based proteins if you're vegan. Beans and lentils are the best source of protein. So I recommend having a lot of that.
Or peas.
Peas are great too, but I prefer beans and lentils over.
Oh, why is that?
So they have a higher protein per serving.
And then how about quinoa?
Quinoa also is high in protein, but not as much as lentils and beans.
Really? Okay, good to know. But that's a great substitute also.
Yeah, it is.
Desiree, what are some other high protein sources of food?
So you can get protein also in dairy products like cheese and yogurt. I prefer to have yogurt because it's less fatty than the cheese. Mm. And I would specifically have Greek yogurt because it does have a higher protein amount.
So is cheese good for us though?
I would have it in moderation. I wouldn't have it too often because it does have a high fat content. So I would really recommend, again, if you're going to have dairy, choose yogurt.
What about these plant protein drinks?
So they do have a lot of fiber and a lot of protein, which is great, but I would use it sparingly because I don't like to drink my calories. So if you have no other option, you can have that, but I'd rather you eat like whole foods like chicken. And
so why don't you like drinking your calories if this is...
It doesn't fill you up the same way as actually eating the food.
So you end up eating too much?
Yes.
Oh, got it. And then, you know, there are things like these protein chips.
So these are processed and filled with a lot of unwanted oils that are unhealthy, like sunflower oil or soybean oil or canola oil. So I really recommend trying to eat whole foods instead of processed packaged foods.
When I get home every day after I work out, I am famished and I just want to get protein and rehydrated as quickly as possible. So I make a protein shake every day.
Okay.
And I use the plant-based proteins. This one's by Four Stigmatic. And I also use collagen, which is also good for my skin, hair, and nails. What do you think about that?
I mean, I think it's great, especially for aging gracefully, because it's so great for the skin and your hair and your nails. And it also is a good source of protein.
Then I put in supplements because I try to eat as healthy as possible, but inevitably I feel like I'm lacking in certain areas. So I've been using CarlsonLabs for over 10 years, and it helps me with energy production, energy recovery, and muscle support and recovery. So specifically, I put into my protein shake Ribose. You can tell this is open because I use these little packets. The Acetyl L Carnitine and the MCT oil, which I love. And then I have like two or three glasses in the fridge because I like to meal prep and have it ready to go. And then I just drink it when I get home. And then I can reward myself with a beautiful salad with turkey and chicken.
That's great.
Yeah. Sometimes I'm so busy, I do my workout, then I've got a meeting, and I don't have a chance to really get a meal afterwards. So I'm really grateful for these portable protein sources, Built. I love Built bars. It's like my protein fix. But ideally, like, what other snacks can I bring with me to give me what my body needs after asking it to do so much by lifting weights and running?
So I think it's great to carry around nuts. Nuts are a great source of protein and fiber. But it's really important to, once you exercise, to have not just protein, but also have good sources of carbohydrates coming from whole grains. Things like quinoa, sweet potatoes, brown rice, whole grain breads. Those are all good sources of carbohydrates. And they have fiber, so it will keep you feeling full. And to also have healthy fat in things like avocado, nuts and seeds, and fish.
Okay, how about red meat? Because red meat has a lot of protein, right?
It has a lot of protein and it has iron. So I actually do recommend eating red meat, not on a daily basis, obviously, but 1 to 2 times a week, I think, is great, especially if you don't have a cholesterol issue.
Oh, good to know, because there's people who say no red meat at all. So I'm glad to see that you're balanced on that. And then we also talk about hydration.
It's so important to drink enough water every day. So especially when you're exercising, you need to up your water intake.
At least 60% of your body and even a larger percentage of your brain is made out of water. So I was taught to drink water while I'm working out so I can hydrate my muscles and joints while I'm in the middle of the workout.
Yes, I recommend taking small sips when you're working out because sometimes for me, it can cause me to become nauseous, but hydrating before and after is important, and taking small sips while you're working out.
Yeah, that's what I do. It's just a small sip, and it's a chance for me to breathe and take a rest. So Desiree, summarize for us, what is eating for fitness?
So eating for fitness, you need to make sure that you're getting enough protein, 1 gram of protein per pound that you weigh, making sure you get good sources of healthy fats and good sources of carbohydrates.
And hydrate.
And hydrating. Yeah. Hydrate.
For sure. Hey, if you're serious about your fitness, or you know somebody who is, or trying to get on that fitness journey, share this video, save it. It really helps them spread the knowledge and the love. It helps us also. And I wanted to thank Desiree Nazarian. She is a nutritionist in Beverly Hills. And this is something that you can't really just do by yourself. Don't just Google on the internet what to eat. When you go in to see Desiree, then she actually analyzes your lifestyle. How are you exercising? Look a little bit about that.
So yeah, you'll come in and we'll go over your lifestyle and see what works for you. Do you eat out all the time? Do you eat at home? How much exercise do you get? How busy are you? And based on all of that, I'm able to come up with a customized meal plan.
and she keeps you accountable. Plus, exactly. She makes modifications because she'll measure your body fat, your muscle percentage,
your basal metabolic rate, so how many calories you burn at rest.
And you are what you eat, so it's so important. Sleep and eat are two of the most important things you do. I just want to say thank you to Bella Paradise for my cute, adorable outfit. I modeled for them in Europe this summer. And Chris, who is the founder and designer, she designs for every age and every body. She covers you in the right places, but exposes you in the right places too. So thank you, Chris, for this outfit. Thank you for watching. Please follow both of us, Desiree and Azarian, on Instagram. I'm on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, you name it. And we hope to see you again. Thank you so much. Oh, and by the way, we did other nutritional eating videos. We did one about emotional eating. We did one on the anti-inflammatory diet. And we did one on
anti-aging
diet. So look for those to get more information about eating right for your body and your lifestyle. Thank you.